Hello everyone, welcome to BizInnovate. I am Neeraj. Sales is very important function of every organization. Selling to existing customers is important. It is also important to find new customers. In my previous video, I have mentioned that sales and marketing work in closed loop. In marketing, we generate leads. And in sales, we work on leads and generate revenue. So what is lead? Lead is a potential customer. And the objective of sales is converting lead to revenue. Our today's topic is about lead management, and we're going to cover following topics in this video. How to create lead? How to qualify lead, duplicate detection rules, routing rules, predictive score models, and who knows whom, and in last, lead to opportunity sales process. So let's start with our demo session. Thank you. We are going to learn how to create new leads. Click on new. Very easy to create lead. Second way is go to activities. If you have an email, there is an option of converting email to lead. Third way is if you have a lot of leads in CSV file, you can also import those leads into system. Now we are going to learn qualification process of leads. Open the lead. You will see a button over here, qualify. Once you click qualify on lead, it generates three items: contact, account, and opportunity by default. Based on the name, it creates contact. Based on the company name, it create account, and based on the name of the topic, it create opportunity. Click on this one. You can see now we have opportunity with this topic and this contact. But sometime based on organization need, we have to change this behavior. So go to settings. Auto create records for newly qualified leads. Disable this. Now, if you qualify this lead, it will show you a dialog box like this. Now, it's your choice to create an account or not. Similarly, for the contact and opportunity. Like in this case, we say do not create contact, only create opportunity. Now we are going to discuss duplicate detection in leads. There are two ways to configure duplicate detection in leads. One is via Power Platform. You can enable or disable at organization level. we can define rules for leads. For example, this says lead with the same email address. It means if two leads have same email address, it will treat as duplicate lead. We also have settings for the duplicate detection in the sales hub. Sales app settings. Here becomes duplicate detection. So here, using machine learning model, AI work on the duplicate detection based on the following rules. It is highly recommended to use this option for the sales hub instead of relying on the Power Platform. Let's play with this setting now. Now we're creating a second lead with same email address. As email address is same, it will identify this as duplicate. So we have option to ignore the lead, or we can merge both the leads, keeping the common data in between. Let's say we want to keep lead 1 and we want to take company data of lead 2 to lead 1. Merge records. Now we have lead 1 and data of company copied from lead 2 to lead 1. Now we are going to discuss lead assignment rules. By default, the person who create lead become the owner of lead. For example, in this lead is owner. But as per the requirement of organization, sometimes need to be allocated to different sellers. For this thing, automation is possible. Sales Insight settings, assignment rules. Here you can make new rule. And options for segments or for all leads. Specific people, specific teams, we can define. Round robin and load balancing are very famous distribution techniques. In earlier days, we used to write code for this, but now it is inbuilt. So you can try out yourself with various options and enjoy the different kind of assignment rules for the lead allocation. Now we are going to discuss predictive lead scoring models. Let's open this lead. You will see lead score over here. So in Dynamics, we have machine learning models which, based on the historical data of leads, can predict the lead score. Lead score is between 1 to 100. So how this lead score comes? Basically, based on different attributes in lead and the associated contact or account is monitored and the score is provided. For example, in this case, it's saying purchase time frame is this quarter. If we click over here, it's mentioned over here. Decision maker identified. Yes. annual revenue is above average. So notice that based on different attribute values, it defines lead score. This box shows you only 5 items. If you want to see more items, which are the reason behind the score, you can click on details. If you want to know more about lead score, you can click on about. It will show you how it works. A salesperson is good to have an idea of this. Higher the score means there is higher probability of winning this lead and converting into opportunities. If admins are not very happy with the score, they can modify the model. But for that, you have to have knowledge of little bit of AI and machine learning, training and testing data. So how a admin will configure the rules further? Predictive lead scoring. More is the historical data, better is model to train. So here admin can do settings and can modify the model and publish again for the improvement in the model. Sometime this widget is not visible on the lead form. So you can customize the form and bring over here. This is known as lead score widget. Now we are going to discuss who knows whom. When you work with a lead, it is always good to have some connect which can introduce to lead. So this box shows colleagues who already have done some communication with the lead. Information in this box is based on the email and the meetings that your colleague have done with the lead earlier. Now we are going to discuss sales process. Every organization have a lot of sellers. It is good practice that all sellers follow the same practice of nurturing the leads. In Dynamics, for leads, there is an out-of-box sales process known as lead to opportunity sales process, which have different items. This sales process can be used by different sellers in most effective way. In case your organization want to modify the sales process or want to apply a new sales process, that is also possible. How? We go to makepowerapps.com, go to default solution, you will find the process. Business process, lead to opportunity sales process. We can modify this one. Let's say in bracket I put my name. You can see the modification. Ideally, it's a good practice to use out of box lead to opportunity sales process, but as per your requirement, you can do modification as well. For complete business process flow learning, we're going to create different video. So far we have discussed everything about lead in this video. Thank you.
To see more demonstrations of this kind, please subscribe. Thank you.